In the day, in the night, in the woods. When he grabbed his crotch, people lost their minds. He did what? He touched there? I think we got a cool one today. This thing here, it's called the Air Bar. Apparently, this device right here attaches to any laptop and turns the screen into a touchscreen. Any laptop. So it comes in a few different sizes. This one is for a 15.6 inch laptop, something in that neighborhood. It looks like there's one available for 14, 13, as well as 11. Plug in. Hard to miss. Jack, when you plug in, is it hard to miss? Touch, just go crazy. Is there innuendo happening here? There's something romantic about this. Your finger, or with gloves, and even a paintbrush. What? Enhanced user experience, pinch, sweep, zoom, scroll. It works with most notebooks running Windows 10, Windows 8.1, and Chrome OS. Okay, we have a fucking MacBook here. You think it'll work? Let's give it a shot. Let's give it a shot. All right, so line it up. Oh, is it me or did that just go? Oh, whoa. The screen is a touchscreen now. Whoa, that's a touchscreen MacBook Pro. Now the question is, how precise is this gonna be? It's close, but maybe you move it more that way. Let's try this. Oh, that's better. It's just a matter of lining it up correctly for your display. But that, my friends, is a touchscreen. Let's try and play a video.
Here, check it out, okay? The removal tool.
The precision is not exactly what I would call pinpoint.
Now the X. That's a special sound. There's...
Get it! It's fine for hitting icons that are huge, but if you're trying to get in on something real small, it is quite frustrating, actually. Now keep in mind, the product officially on the back states the compatibility, Windows 10, Windows 8.1, and Chrome OS. In my experience, the drivers that exist, generally speaking, for items like this, accessories like this, can function on Mac OS, sometimes maybe with a little bit less polish. I've got Pixelmator open. This will tell us how close it is to the actual tap point. What's going on here? Whoa. Oh, so that's not working. It does work, which is cool, but this is the point of the video where you cut and you go, okay, I got a PC laptop now. Let's see what the difference is. Okay, I got a PC laptop now. Let's see what the difference is. I can tell right away when I line up the Air Bar, that fit is precise. So I'm gonna remove the little sticky parts. These little white lines fit perfectly. When you lift this off, you'll see the little tiny magnets stay there. You put those magnets on, fold this down, it works as you'd expect. But then when you want to use the Air Bar, it just drops on to the right position. You want to apparently have a little tiny gap above the edge of the Air Bar. Windows found the driver. This is Windows 7 Pro. It found the driver, apparently. Oh, this is way better than on the MacBook. Way, way better. Oh, it's bang on precise. It's super precise. Let's see if I can grab the little scroll over here. Wow. Oh, it's not even comparable to the other one. I don't think that has to do with the software. That's the thing. I think if this company made one that was the exact form factor of the MacBook display, something tells me where. Oh, they just launched YouTube Rewind. You never know. You might see your old pal Lou in there. Oh, look, it even realizes I might want touch input as well for the text. Let's open up Paint here. Oh, baby. Do a little Jack attack here. There he is, Mr. Pixel Jack. Lot of ear. He's also been working out, so he's a little more buff than usual. Those are his muscles right there. That's like a proper touchscreen. I hope you're getting that. That's beyond my expectations for precision. Not functioning so well on a MacBook Pro, but that's not what it's designed for, so who cares? Here, in Windows, bang on precision. You can see the size, or trying to hit like an X. Let's see this little X right here. Boom! And it's not like you're completely committed to it. I like the way they designed it in the sense of, you wanna get rid of it? Okay, boom. I think this thing's pretty cool. I can see a number of different circumstances in which touch could be a cool thing to experiment with, maybe for artistic endeavors.
It's a touchscreen for any laptop. Look at it. That's all it takes.